Hey everybody, welcome back to another edition here of the Washington Football Maniacs. If you're new here, welcome to the channel. I hope you enjoy what you're watching here. And if you are, please consider subscribing as it helps to support this channel. And with that said, let's get into today's content. So, Ron Rivera came out and said that he is wanting to add a veteran quarterback. He wants to have another veteran quarterback, and he wants to add a rookie quarterback to this year's Washington Commanders roster. So you can kind of dissect this any way you want it, but here is what I think may help happen. I think right now, certainly Ron Rivera and company, they're looking at all the situations that may appear during free agency and, of course, before that, you know, trade scenarios with some of these other quarterbacks that have been mentioned. Of course, you know, I still am holding on to the belief that we're going to somehow take a big swing and get Russell Wilson here. Maybe I'm very optimistic. I really would love to have Russell Wilson here in Washington playing, because I think he's going to give the team the best opportunity to be instant contenders. But let's just say that Russell Wilson doesn't come to Washington. Let's say that he winds up staying in Seattle. Then what are the other choices, right? So the other choices, well, you got Carson Wentz, who has been in, I guess, the news here lately. The Colts are pretty much cutting him, which is kind of interesting given the fact that they gave up what was the first round and the second round pick for Carson Wentz, and now they're cutting him a year later. I mean, talking about red flags, there are a lot of red flags on that. Why would you do that, right? So Carson Wentz is going to be available, and then you got other names, of course. Deshaun Watson has been coming up for the last 2 years, and we are most certainly trying to figure out what his legal issues are going to be, how are they going to be solved, when are they going to be solved, and when they are going to be solved, who does he want to go and play for, right? So that's one to look out for. And then you got Jimmy Garoppolo, which everybody seems to be like, yeah, I know he's been to the Super Bowl a couple of times, but, you know, for some reason, he's not really anybody's favorite. He's not really my favorite. I would dare say that I think Heineke could push him in training camp. Probably could even beat him out as a starter. So I don't know if trying to give up any picks for Jimmy Garoppolo would honestly be a great move. Now, I did mention this on my Twitter a few days ago, you know, when I heard about, oh, you know, the 49ers are asking for a second round pick for Jimmy G. And then I'm like, okay, second round pick. You still have your first round pick. You can get a quarterback in the first round. So you can get any of these quarterbacks in the first round that guys have been talking about. You can get Jimmy G. So you got that a veteran quarterback added. You still got Taylor Heineke and, of course, Kyle Allen, and you've got that rookie quarterback. That is the scenario that fits what Ron Rivera is talking about. Now, that may not be the most popular scenario that everybody else would like to hear, because obviously when you look at the quarterback depth this year in the draft, it's not deep, right? And so you're probably not really going to be adding what I consider very good quarterbacks. Honestly, outside of these quarterbacks, the Corrales and guys like that, the four or the five that have been mentioned, I don't know who else is coming out and trying to get into the draft that's going to be worth a look, right? So are you going to be adding that rookie quarterback this year? And honestly, by the sound of it, it almost sounds like with the projections that none of these quarterbacks are going to be true starters. And, you know, then again, we hear all of this stuff every single year, and then it turns out to be that most of the time, all of these predictions fail, right? You know, there was talk about Tom Brady. You know, look at Tom Brady. Was not very athletic. He was slow. You know, if you look at him during his scouting combine and all that stuff. I mean, pro day or whatever it was back in those days. You know, Tom Brady did not look like a Hall of Fame quarterback at all. And I think he was drafted in the sixth round, if I'm not mistaken. And yet he's going to be a Hall of Fame quarterback. He's the GOAT, right? So, I mean, you just never know. You never know what you're going to get. And but, you know, with Ron Rivera saying he wants to add a rookie quarterback, is he saying that this year? So if he's saying that he wants to add a rookie quarterback this year, he's almost as if he's showing his hand, you know, in this card game that he's going to hang on to that number 11 spot. And he's going to try to pick up a quarterback that's not going to require that first round draft pick in a trade, which may spell, you know, some disappointment to some of us fans who are hoping for a Russell Wilson, you know, a guys like that, or Deshaun Watson, you know, for that matter. It might be more of a Jimmy Garoppolo, and might be more of a Carson Wentz, guys like that. That doesn't really make a lot of people excited, and it doesn't really make a lot of people want to go out and start, you know, purchasing tickets. And you do start to question, are these guys really going to be that much better than what we have in Taylor Heineke? I think as far as athleticism with, you know, with the throwing arms and stuff like that, I mean, you know, Taylor Heineke does lack in that area. He does not have a very strong arm, and we've seen this. He does have the athletic ability to scramble, to make plays. He's an exciting player, but he doesn't have a strong arm. We need somebody with a better arm. Wentz does have a better arm. Jimmy Garoppolo, I question. I don't think Jimmy Garoppolo has a very strong arm. Maybe slightly stronger than Taylor Heineke, but I haven't seen, you know, from what I've watched Jimmy G play, it's been a lot of those short slant passes, you know, the West Coast offense that made Joe Montana famous, except the fact that, you know, Joe Montana still had the arm. He could get the ball downfield if he had to. Jimmy G, I don't, you know, I always kind of question his arm strength. And maybe he has slightly better arm strength than Taylor Heineke, but I just don't know if he would be a better choice. But if I had to guess right now, realistically, I would tell you that if I was putting money and bets on this, I would say that, you know, when we get to the 2022 roster starting, more than likely, you're probably going to wind up having Carson Wentz or Jimmy Garoppolo. And then behind that, you're going to have Taylor Heineke, and then you're going to have a rookie quarterback who's been drafted, probably drafted with that number 11 pick. That's what I feel like is going to happen. And Ron Rivera is probably thinking, these guys are not ready to play, but if they're good enough to be drafted that high, then at least, you know, it's a weird situation. It's such a weak quarterback class this season, but it's not to say that these quarterbacks are not NFL caliber. It's just these quarterbacks, compared to other classes, are probably not likely to be ready to step in day one and play and really, you know, become like a next, you know, Mahomes or somebody like that. These guys need to be able to play behind veteran leadership for at least a year. And then they'll be ready. And so that may be what Ron Rivera is thinking. You know, draft one of these guys at number 11, bring in a Carson Wentz. You can argue Mitch Trubisky. I don't know. Again, Mitchell. I don't know if he would be any better, again, than Taylor Heinicke, honestly. I think you would probably have another year where quarterback position would be a question mark. And Ron Rivera knows he's got to get a franchise quarterback. And it may be better for him to go out and get somebody he knows that's had a good amount of success starting. Now, I know that Mitch has had some success early on in his career, but for the most part, I think Carson Wentz has had a better start of his career, and then he's been shaky. Jimmy, though, you can argue has had the probably the most success, having taken his team to two Super Bowls. Despite that, you know, I just don't know athletically if he's any better than Taylor Heinicke. But all in all, I think it's going to come down to Carson Wentz or Jimmy Garoppolo. And knowing that, we already know what's going to cost for Jimmy Garoppolo. And likely it's not going to cost anything for Carson Wentz. Those are two great options when it comes down to what's going to cost the team. It's likely that Ron Rivera is going to be happy to give up a second for Jimmy Garoppolo and then use that first and draft one of these other quarterbacks and then essentially be in the same position as what San Francisco was in this past season and hope that they can at least, you know, get as far as, you know, into the playoffs necessarily, but, you know, into a divisional round of the playoffs, consider it a success, you know, give Jimmy Garoppolo kind of a, you know, a show me type of contract, not a very long contract, give some time for the rookie guy to, you know, develop into something a little bit franchisey. And hope that things go well from there. So I think that's what's, honestly, I think that's what's going to happen. Still, I'm holding out for Russell Wilson because I think ultimately Russell Wilson could take this team to a Super Bowl. Would definitely give this team instant credibility. Is it going to happen? Part of me wants to say yes. Couple of videos back, I said, that's exactly what's going to happen. We're going to have Russell Wilson. He's going to sign here. And he still may do it. He still may do it. But the more realistic side of me is saying, yeah, it's going to cost us a whole lot. If, you know, Ron Rivera's coming out saying he wants a rookie quarterback and he's going to draft that guy this year, he's already showing his hand, which means that he's taking a step back from Russell Wilson already, and he's saying, you know what, let's get Jimmy Garoppolo, let's get Carson Wentz, and then let's go draft one of these other quarterbacks, and we're going to roll with that for 2022. That's probably what's going to happen.